Friends, welcome back for our present video. In previous video, we discussed about importance of digital education. Today, we'll make an attempt to understand how this digital learning procedure or technique can be compared with traditional educational method. And I hope that at the end of this video, you will make definitely one important conclusion whether we can go with digital learning technology or with the traditional educational method only. So I hope that you will definitely like this video. So we'll now start with this particular discussion. So keep watching. So we are now discussing about digital learning versus traditional educational method. During this video, some important points will make it focused. One of them is digital learning makes students smarter or not. Second one, the digital learning process or technique is a technique of making the students self-motivated and more accountable or not. Third point, digital learning tool involves educator and parents to a deeper extent or not. Of course, these all questions are in comparison with a traditional educational system. Fourth, we are discussing that is digital learning tool and technology is rapidly increasing informative and information sharing, whether it is true or not, and why traditional method is not that much popular. Increasing students' employability with digital learning tools and technology, and ultimately, very big question, traditional education method have to be get replaced or not. So, as far as goes with the digital learning process, how beneficial it is for the students? So, as you know, digital learning is replacing traditional education methods more and more every day. With how rapidly classrooms are changing, it is best to forget methods you may remember from when you were in a school and start thinking about a newer teaching as well as learning techniques based on digital learning tools and technologies. The inclusion of digital learning in the classroom can vary from simply using the tablets instead of a paper to using elaborate software programs and equipments as opposed to the simple pen. This could until using the sites, services, programs, teaching tools and technologies like study aids built for at-home use. Even a social networks and communications platforms can be used to create and manage digital assignments and different agendas. Of course, irrespective of how much technology is integrated into the classroom, digital learning has come to play a crucial role in education. It empowers students by getting them to be more interested in learning and expanding their horizons. Here is how digital learning is a step up from traditional educational method. As I have mentioned here, that digital learning makes students smarter or not. Let's start to think on it. You know that that learning tools and technology enable students to develop effective self-directed learning skills. They are able to identify what they need to learn, find and use online resources, apply the information on the problem at hand, and even evaluate resultant feedback. This increases their efficiency and productivity. In addition to engaging students, digital learning tools and technology sharpen critical thinking skills, which are the basis for development of analytical reasoning. So children who explore open-ended questions with imagination and logic learn how to make decisions, as opposed to just temporarily memorizing the textbook, which was happening in case of traditional educational system. Educational tools by Young Digital Planet, such as BingeL Stage Learn, to children how to collaborate and work successfully in groups. This platform gives you that information. This is typically done through gamifications, and gamification is a great feature of certain softwares of interactive learning, because it teaches children playing in a group to depend on and trust each other in order to win a game or achieve their goals. See, for school kids it is really very useful. They also promote some cooperations and teamwork, which are very important skills in every aspect of life. Another thing, that is interactive social skill games, if we can use for teaching learning process, they are always stood as excellent learning tools that a student start to learn discipline, because playing the game requires children to follow the rules, regulations, guidelines in order to participate, and therefore they become much more obedient and disciplined, well disciplined. Even children who might grow frustrated with other learning methods may stick with the game longer, because playing itself is rewarding, and this ends up helping them develop patience, another useful life skill. Excuse me. The students also develop positive feelings of accomplishment from mastering new knowledge and skills using digitalized learning tools, giving them the confidence they need to want to learn even more new things. It is commendable that millions of courses by the best educator are available for free to anyone with an internet connection, and the possibilities are endless, definitely. Excuse me. Another question is that digital learning is making students self-motivated and more accountable or not. Let's have a discussion on it. Students using digital learning tools and technologies become more engaged in the process and more interested in growing their knowledge base. They may not even realize that they are actively learning, since they are learning through engaging methods such as peer education, teamwork, problem solving, reverse teaching, concept maps, gamifications, tagging, role playing and storytelling, and so on. So since digital learning is far more interactive and memorable than the voluminous textbook or one-sided lectures, they provide better context, a great sense of perspective and more engaging activities than traditional education method. So this allows students to better connect with the learning material. Further, they often offer a more interesting and involving way to digest information. This is reflected in their retention rates and test scores also. When students can track their own progress, it can improve motivation and accountability. That's why it is true. Digital learning is making students self-motivated and more accountable. Let's have a discussion on digital learning tools involve educator and parents to a deeper extent or not. As you know, learning tools and technologies like social learning platforms make it easy for teachers, professors, educators to create and manage the groups. The shift to digital learning can approximate the benefits of tutoring while clearing of time for teachers to address individual and small group needs. The opportunity to customize learning sequences for each student will make education more productive by closing learning gaps sooner and accelerating progress. Dynamic grouping, workshops, and project-based learning can add lots of collaborative learning to the already present educational model. I'm not going to scrap the existing model. We're trying to modify it. Padmod Education provides, there is one more educational platform, that is online platform, that provides the lesson planning tools for educators. There are many such platforms out there which can be provide you the platform, and nowadays EduX, it is providing you Coursera, it is providing you, and so on. One of them is a Padmod. Educators can also join online professional learning communities to ask questions and share tips and stay connected with a global educator community. They can keep themselves updated with the most relevant content for their curriculum using such a learning tools which are available in open access or little bit in paid versions. Platform. One of them was, as I told you, Padmod Education. Apart from educators, parents can use interactive activities to encourage their children. Of course, the role of parents in children's life is very important. I am not talking about the higher education at present with the context to the school children or school students. It is really very, very important. So they can encourage their child's interest in learning, since gamification makes the process much more enjoyable and interesting. Parents can also explore online learning activities with their child, which can serve as an extension to what they are learning in their classroom. Digital learning tools and technology provides enjoyment for the kids as well as numerous benefits in terms of developing a child's well-being. Everyone benefits with the digitalization of learning. So, digital learning tools and technology is rapidly increasing information sharing. Absolutely true. Excuse me. In recent years, the shift from the print to digital has impacted how we learn. Just as printing press did 6 centuries ago, this transition is transforming formal education and increasing learning opportunities. Digital learning is not only allowing students to access more and more information, but also ensuring that the information is a question is customizable and suited to their personal needs. The opportunity to help every student learn at the best pace and path for them is the most important benefit of digital learning. Digital learning tools and technology enable educators to rapidly share information with other educators in real-time basis. The explosion of free and open content and tools has created an environment of sharing economy. You have to agree with this. By embracing digital devices and connected learning, classrooms around the country and around the globe can not only coordinate with one another to share insights, but also boost learning experience and communication skills also. The practice also allows educators to enjoy a level playing field. Schools, colleges, they can save money while ensuring the equitable access to the educational material as expensive private school or colleges. Think of it. Now, increasing students' employability with digital learning tools and technology. Is it true or not? Equipping students with the requirement of higher education and holding a career at young age has become one of the most crucial responsibility of school education and followed by the undergraduate programs. Digital learning solutions based on problem-based learning emphasizes on learning methods that are constructive, collaborative, and calls the students' attention to a real-world approach to learning. With the ongoing employment crisis throughout the world, it is crucial that if young people are unable to find the jobs, they should have the ability to create their own and ideally even generate jobs for the others. For this purpose, newer methods of learning and education needs to be incorporated into the schools as well as undergraduate, postgraduate curriculums, starting right from elementary school, of course. So digital learning tools and technologies in elementary schools as well as secondary and high schools as well as 12 plus, the students for they will get benefited for career build. They will definitely acquire these skills, including problem solving and familiarity with emerging technologies and self-motivation. Now, if we look all this what we have so far discussed, now there may be one question arises in your mind, and that is also of course very important question. Does traditional education method have to be get replaced? Think on it. Why? Why there is a threat to be get arise in your mind that traditional education method had to be get replaced? Why it happens? You know, traditional lectures may still exist along with the new age learning tools and technology. But the lecture material should be provided as a supplement to classroom activities and moved online for students to reference outside of the classroom. Classroom time is better used for discussing the curriculum, engaging in activities with the team and completing the class projects. Students often have the option to pace their learning and even study ahead with digital learning tool if they wish to do so. This is one of the liberty. By helping children or students think outside their typical learning modes, digital learning inspires creativity and lets students feel a sense of accomplishment that encourages is further learning. Digital learning tools and technology fill the gaps where traditional classroom teaching falls behind. In fact, some of the efficiency research tools bring are simply unmatchable by traditional learning techniques. You have to agree with this. From the environmental impact recognized by the need for less paper for handouts and books to saving time with quick access to information and the ease of research, digital learning provides an effective way to cut costs, maximize the resources, and heighten both reach and impact for students and educators alike. So, these are all points of a discussion. They help us to make our own opinion. It enables you to find out a conclusion that when we compare the digital learning along with the traditional education method, definitely digital education or digital learning methods, they have a lot of benefits. But all these benefits can be given to the students based on, of course, also traditional method of knowledge that actually enable you to utilize your skills by using the tools, or you simply call them as a techniques given by the modern technology. So we have to adopt the modern technology to incorporate it in our traditional pattern. So I hope that this much information, it will be much more significant for you for further discussions which we are making regarding online, how online classes, how online education it may be given, and for the purpose, what are the prerequisites, in what we can get familiarized with these tools and techniques. So we'll in next video we'll go ahead with a little bit instructive demonstrations, and you can exercise that also. So far for listening this video very carefully and patiently, thank you very much. See you next time.